My name's Delaney Steele Brown, and I'm a Alpine, Ontario coach in Southern Ontario. I raced for 10 years, and in all that time, I had one female coach. Now that I'm a coach, I find that a lot of the young girls who are racing will come to me instead of the typically older male coaches that are seen in Alpine, Ontario. It can be extremely intimidating standing in the start, getting ready to fling yourself down a ski hill as fast as you can.
Red side, ready! Blue side, ready! Racers, ready!
Having a coach to talk to about your fears on race days is exactly why there needs to be more female coaches for the female athletes.
Be an Alpine skier for Canada, and I raced at the World Cup level for many years. I did two Olympics in 2006 and 2010, and I think two or three World Championships. Now I am a mom of four young kids, and I'm living in Calgary, Alberta. So my mom was the only female coach I had, and that was from 12 to 14 years old.
Why do you think that there aren't a lot of female coaches?
It's definitely been a male-dominated sport, I think, in the past. I definitely have seen more female coaches in the last, like, I want to say 5 years, and especially at the younger level, where I think that's pretty important. Girls between the ages of like 12 and 16, like 80% of them end up quitting their sport and just either, you know, they're not involved in either a team or individual sport. So I don't know. It's either that the industry has been male dominated, and as women we feel slight intimidation from that, or that they just either once they get older they decide to start a family. If you think back of when you were like this young girl coming up, and if you had this amazing role model female like coaching, then you know you want to be that person, or you want to be able to help those young girls get through that. I think if they have that type of role model for someone to like understand, okay, when you're working on technical stuff, but they can also kind of talk to them about like what's going on either with their confidence levels or like what you can do to just be better emotionally and physically and mentally. When you're sitting talking to your physio all the time, it's almost like you can kind of vent or bounce off any of your thoughts and emotions with them. And most of ours were female, so I found that there was a connection definitely with the physios, and they kind of see both sides. You know, they're not on the coach's side of things with like the technical issues. They're just trying to like make you better physically, but also it was like this little mini mental session for like a little break, I guess.
Hi, I'm Bill Reel. I'm from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. I am 50 years old. I started coaching when I was 20 years old. I coached with the Southern Ontario Ski Team, the Ontario Ski Team, the Timmins Ski Club, and then Lake Superior Ski Club, and then the National Ski Team.
Is there a drastic ratio difference between female and male coaches?
There is, and I don't know why that is, because in our club here, we have a lot of young girls that were ex-racers that are now coaching with us, and they do a great job. They're more organized than some of our younger male coaches, and so it's great to have them on the staff. Maybe it's just the profession that, you know, female coaches don't want to do. It's kind of a different lifestyle. You do a lot of traveling and a lot of time that if you're not with a big staff, you are by yourself a lot.
Would you say that female and male athletes ski differently?
I don't think they ski differently. You teach them the same techniques.
Overcoming fears, especially in speed, is a big thing with the female athletes compared to the guys.
Do you think that female athletes would better benefit from female coaches?
I think so. When I was coaching with the National Ski Team, I was coaching the junior girls. And so some races we would meet up in Europe with the older World Cup girls that would come down and ski Europa Cups. And if I was not getting through to some of the girls, I would go to them for advice.
Jeff Priddle.
And from what you've seen in races and your time coaching, was there a drastic ratio difference between female and male coaches?
There always has been. Locally, I think we've had some good young girls, but I think in the higher levels, head coaches is definitely male dominated. It's men that tend to stay in longer, and it's got to be tough for women to break through that.
Do you think there's a reason why males stay in the program longer and go higher up?
I think they like standing around on the hill, bossing kids around. Having kids think they know everything.
Do you think in terms of the athletes, having more female coaches would improve the athlete's experience?
Well, how can you not doubt that a female's point of view is important to any, from a racer to a kid? So I think there could be losing a lot of that, what the motivation might be for those kids. If you don't have that same ratio, I think that you're missing some opportunity there.
We're taking